Welcome to my economy guide for Beyond All Reason. Because BARD does not have a uniform start on its many maps, nor the same conditions for energy production and metal extraction, there isn't a single opening build to follow. While this makes it even harder to learn the game, it also makes each match less predictable and more fun. This is why I will now do my best to teach you about the economy so you can adapt your playstyle to different conditions, starting positions or roles which you play in battles. I'm going to limit my guide to two of the most popular 8v8 maps and one of the 1v1 maps and use the Armada faction as it will be familiar to you across my other guides which are linked in the description of this video. And in case you want to go for a nuclear missile rush build, I have a video on that playlist covering that topic too. Since so many new players start multiplayer on the old That Glitters 8v8 map, here is how you eco and build units for the first few minutes on the middle front position. Because the commander spawns in turn towards the enemies, I put the first metal mechs up, then left, and pre-plan for a wind turbine next to each new mechs. If the wind is low, I will switch to a solar collector. This time the wind is just at the edge of usefulness, so I take a gamble and keep using wind turbines. Four of these with average wind is sufficient for you to build a vehicle lab, which is the best choice for this frontline starting position. While building the lab, I order a constructor, 5 scouts and 2 more constructors, while the next building is another wind turbine and the commander will boost the lab's build power once that one is finished. As the first constructor is being built, I can already give it a command to build new mechs all the way to the front line by holding shift and right clicking. There is also an area build command using alt and dragging, but sometimes I prefer to choose the path manually. Next you need new wind turbines once you drain the yellow energy bar. As that energy bar gets closer to full, you can add an energy storage building to your build queue using shift and it will let you store more energy when the wind is high and use it when the wind is low. This is especially necessary so you have energy for using the D-gun weapon or stealth with your commander on the front line. Depending on the wind and your stored energy power, you can add more wind turbines or help the vehicle lab build units. Scouts need to cover the front line and give you vision, while the next constructor vehicle needs to take over from your commander in helping the lab produce units faster as you send him to the front. There you need to capture the metal mechs with the highest income, protect it with the laser towers and have a radar station so you can see enemy movement in the fog of war. The third construction vehicle can keep growing your economy with wind turbines. The other one can be used to build energy converters if you have good wind and high energy income, which is represented by the green number at the top yellow bar. It will turn the extra energy into metal and give you a higher income on the left gray bar, which you need to produce vehicles as they are metal heavy. If the enemy isn't pushing you, you can get one more constructor. If he is pushing with units, go straight to blitz tanks. Janus rocket launchers are fantastic at destroying enemy laser towers and even destroying a commander with their high damage. The Stouts are HP high tanks with medium damage, while Whistlers are long-range minimal damage missile trucks which can target enemy air units. The Shellshockers are medium-range artillery that is excellent for destroying enemy towers without coming into their range. Due to how wind is unpredictable, you can always expect to be low on energy or wasting it with only wind turbines. You can give your extra energy to your teammates or just construct more energy converters. If you have a lot of metal and energy, that is the perfect time to increase your build power. This is basically a third resource type in Beyond All Reason and a very important one. Because gaining resources is nothing if you can't spend them fast enough to produce units and buildings. And you produce both with build power. This is why adding a constructor turret early to your base and in the range of your labs and metal extractors is a must, especially as you upgrade those metal extractors to level 2, which takes not just a lot of energy and metal, but also time, which you reduce by having more build power. Essentially, build power allows you to add energy and metal into a construction or recruitment project faster, which is a must as everything costs progressively more in the second and third tech tiers. At the start of a match, the commander and your constructors are your main source of build power, but as the match progresses, it is these construction turrets. They are weak and can be blown up by the smallest of units, which is why you need to both space them out and protect them. If your front is calm, you can always speed up the building of more metal maxes with your commander, but also must cover them with turrets or units. As you can see, by the 5th minute, my income of energy and metal is at an almost equal level to my expenses, meaning I have just about the right amount of build power in use for the amount of resources I am producing. You will always go out of balance for short periods of time as new build power becomes operational or new energy or metal sources go online. This is normal and to be expected, but it is your job to keep this triangle of metal, energy and build power in a constant balance. If you have accumulated about 500 metal at this point, it is your opportunity to send it to your economy-focused teammate who will send you a T2 constructor which will work on upgrading your metal maxes to the second level, and that will massively boost your metal income. It is also costly in metal and energy, as I said before, so you have to have some metal and energy in the bank, as well as sufficient build power so the upgrading of these maxes doesn't take forever. Alright, now let's move on to a different map and a totally different approach to building an economy. This is the Supreme Isthmus map, and its starting positions are quite different, as well as the environment. Because this map doesn't just have a lot of rocks containing metal like on all the glitters, but also trees containing energy. Since we covered a front position on the previous map, let's do a map position on this one that is about the second tech level and being a front player who brings in heavy guns to the battle. On this spot and map, the commander spawns in turned down, which is why the first metal extractor is built there and the second up on top, while we watch the wind indicator to see what is best to use at start. And with the wind remaining so low, a solar collector is a better choice. Two solar collectors are enough to start producing bots, so a bot lab is placed next, and especially as we need the reclaim bot that we will use to turn all these trees into free energy. As the commander boosts the build power in the bot lab, we have to give each new reclaim bot an exclusive reclaim area where it will work and turn trees into energy. Once the commander uses up most of the energy, we need to go back to building more energy generation, depending of course on the current wind strength. The job for this first bot constructor is the fourth metal extractor because we want to keep the commander close by the lab because of his much greater build power. Once the first reclaim bot starts turning trees into energy, we start getting a massive boost in the energy income and can use it to both boost the production in the lab and build the next metal extractor. Since this spot is both energy and metal rich at the start, we can plan for a construction turret immediately and just keep building more reclaim bots to keep increasing the energy income, but also to collect all nearby metal rich rocks. This is why an energy storage building is a must to prevent wasting energy and why you can start converting energy to metal so soon with many energy converter buildings. Using up your resources on this spot is very important, as the more you spend, the more you invest into new economy buildings, increasing your metal and energy incomes, allowing you to get to the second tech level on your own and get to building second tech level units as soon as possible to help your frontline players. The energy income from the bots reclaiming trees won't last forever, as trees will be spent in a few minutes, which is why it is so important to have a forest of wind turbines quickly, and because this map has a very high maximum wind speed. All that energy getting converted into metal is your ticket to an early T2 lab, which is very metal expensive. Building energy converters and wind turbines is your priority here, as that is the economy that must produce about 2000 extra metal for you to be able to reclaim the original bot lab and at the same time build up the second tier bot lab. But before you get to that point, you must add a metal storage building to your build queue, as the reclaimed metal can overflow your storage and you won't be able to use it. You should keep track of your reclaim bots for several reasons. First of all, they can run into a spot where your allies have already reclaimed everything and stop working. Second, they can get close to an active battle zone, and third, you might be able to get some metal left over from a fight. Any such additional scrap of metal early on will help you greatly. Trying to build inside the build range of your construction turret is a good idea, as it will boost every construction project on automatic mode, but you can manually choose what it will work on if you have a specific project that you want finished sooner with more build power. Your commander has the single highest build power value, so he can work alone, but construction bots need all the help they can get. Now at about 2000 metal in the bank, you can start reclaiming your first tech level bot lab with your construction turret and give a con bot the order to build the second tech level bot lab. You should then help the construction project with your commander and turret as soon as possible to finish it faster. If the wind strength is kind to you on the map you're playing on, this will all be finished sooner rather than later, but a T2 transition at about 6 or 7 minutes is totally okay. Once the T2 lab is completed, you need to start producing a T2 bot constructor unit and give it the order to upgrade your metal maxes to their second tech level versions. These increase the amount of metal extracted by a lot, bringing your economy to a totally new level. This is also a resource expensive transition, so if you were building units for a fight, you might have to pause that for a minute or two to let your economy upgrade, as the faster you get that higher income, the more units you will be able to produce and faster. Now, what can help you during this transition period is using the Butler unit built at the T2 bot lab, as they have much higher movement speed and 140 build power and can construct additional forests of wind turbines much faster than T2-1 bots, especially outside the range of your construction turrets. These butlers can also assist your T2 bot construction unit to upgrade metal maxes which aren't close to your base and your construction turrets. One thing I have to say is that I am not a beyond all reason pro, and I don't claim to be able to construct a fantastic base or quickly, but I am here to try and explain all the units and economy building process so you can become such pros in the future. Anyway, when you see that you have a stable income, you can work on improving your build power by adding more con turrets, which should be concentrated next to your lab and the position where you will build future fusion reactors and more advanced energy to metal converters. One trick you should learn is the touch and go construction. What this means is that you command your advanced construction bot to build a fusion reactor, for example, next to your base, and keep on moving towards other metal extractors marked for upgrading. It isn't necessary for a T2 con bot to remain next to a building once it has placed its project down. Other units which have build power can keep on building it. At this point of your eco upgrade, your main objective is to start building these fusion reactors for their massive stable production of energy, and then alternate between a fusion reactor and a T2 energy converter, as such reactors can produce enough power to keep one such converter online. You can also produce more units instead of energy converters using this extra power, but that will of course depend on the situation at the front, which you as the front player should keep track of on this map, despite also having the job to bring T2 units to the battlefield with your superior eco position. Of course, the more your economy grows, the more your build power must grow as the third resource. So always keep an eye on your income and keep adding more constructor turrets as your stored energy and metal grows. One mistake I often make is constructing multiple resource-intensive construction projects at the same time. Like in this example of me building both a fusion reactor and a T2 converter at the same time. This just makes everything go slower, which is the exact opposite of what you should be doing. Now, after a lot more wind turbines, fusion reactors, energy converters, and construction turrets, you should have a thriving economy capable of supporting the most expensive energy generating building, the advanced fusion reactor. Once this one comes online, you will have enough energy for several new T2 energy converters just off its energy production. Since you will start running out of room for future such huge buildings and you already have a stable income of energy, you can order your construction turrets to reclaim wind turbines closest to them and free up the space. This isn't exactly optimal, but it keeps the base small and everything in range of the counters you already have. As with all complex games, there isn't a single answer to how you should be doing things. With a high enough income and enough build power, you will now be able to add more and more advanced fusion reactors and energy converters, but do remember, I wasn't recruiting units during this build. While you will have to join the fight, and so building the base will take considerably longer. Now let's jump to a very different map, players usually use for 1v1 matches. This one has close to no wind, so you are forced to use only solar collectors, which cost just metal to produce and give a fixed income of energy. Playing only maps which have wind and jumping into such a map can be a very jarring experience, and you can expect to mess up your economy really easily. You will spend your entire energy supply just building the first 3 maxes, then a lot of metal on solar collectors, and will be left with just enough metal for your vehicle lab, which is a good choice on this map due to the large number of metal spots. Expanding your eco requires walking the commander unit forward to capture new mechs and protect them with towers, while back at the base your constructor unit will help the lab produce new units and add more solar collectors. Don't be afraid to add more solar collectors with your commander too as you move it across the map, as balancing the resources on this map with no useful wind is not easy and takes a while to learn. Lastly, we can look at how on the Old Dead Glitters 8v8 map you have a much different start and eco build when you take the back frontline position. This one gives you just 6 metal spots in total, but you have a lot of metal-rich rocks around your starting position. Because of this, the bot lab is a good choice to be able to produce the reclaim bots we talked about before and give them the order to reclaim all this metal. Wind turbines and energy converters rule the day here as well, but while I won't be sending my commander off to the front in this example, you will need to in order to properly play the multiplayer meta on this map. It is possible to do a full eco start on this spot and do a self-made transition to tech 2 in about 6 or 7 minutes, but this means expecting your teammates to be fighting 2 versus 3 on the front line. This is something that should only be done if you plan it out with your teammates and they agree to such a plan. I hope this guide will unlock your potential as a good bar player, and to help you more, I have made other guides and videos, including one dedicated to playing on the air position, and will post more combat-focused guides soon. Thank you for watching, and I wish you all happy gaming.